Diocese of Covington plans to hold in-person graduations at its 9 high schools this year. Graduates will be socially distant. Families will be sitting in groups and masks will be worn. Bishop Rogers Foys will present each graduate with his or her diploma. Schools in the diocese are also updating their COVID protocols. Temperatures will no longer be taken each morning. Families need to do that at home before kids arrive. In-person meetings will resume with those attending wearing a mask and social distancing. And the district has simplified rules for school sports. Schools in the Diocese of Covington have been able to have in-person classes for nearly the entire year. And students aren't even out for the summer, but schools around the tri-state are starting to make important plans for next fall. One big decision involves keeping or taking away a virtual option to learn. Local 12's Alexa Helwig tells us what lies behind that decision.
Most Norwood students are back in a classroom 5 days a week. Last August, Superintendent Mary Ronan says some families were hesitant about in-person learning.
We felt the 550 students who started in the program really got as great an education as you possibly could virtually.
Second semester, that number dropped to 300. There is not much guidance yet from the state, and so few families are interested in a virtual option. Next fall, Norwood won't offer it.
We just know a tiny district like ours cannot run a separate virtual program that's quality and do right by our children and our families.
And Norwood's 12 virtual teachers are needed in classrooms to keep class sizes small. In Mason, school administration surveyed families last month.
And we actually only had 1.7% of our families say that they were still interested in an online option.
Tracy Carson says the district heard from families. Students miss the social connection with their classmates. Mason won't offer a virtual option either.
They're watching what in-person learning has been like for their neighbors and friends and finding that they do think it's a safe place to go to school.
A spokeswoman for Lakota Schools says while about 25% of students return to in-person learning in January, we understand there are still families who would prefer a virtual option. We will offer it for students in grades K through 12 next year. Alexa Helwig, Local 12 News.
For families who do want to stay virtual, schools will work with them on an individual basis.